Hey guys, how you all doing? I know that the majority of the YouTubers always uploads a video on the 1st of January, and I even saw people that were filming themselves like 5 past 12 on New Year's Eve. And it's not that I don't want to, but I just can't. I mean, before I wake up and everything again, it's January 2nd, and I just like to sleep out, and I got other stuff to do, like sleeping out, and I just like to sleep out. So of course I want to wish you all a very happy and a musically brutal new year, and especially a healthy new year, because I heard that here in Holland there were quite a number of people who had to go through surgery because they got fireworks in their eyes. And I don't want to spoil the fun, but I'm not really a fan of fireworks. I mean, I'm just fine. I don't set off fireworks. I don't like fireworks, and I think it's a little strange actually, because, well, normally you're not allowed to carry a Swiss Army knife in your pocket, but on New Year's Eve even the little kids walk around in a neighborhood with enough gunpowder and enough explosives to blow up an entire house. You know, just, yeah, it's not for me. Like I said, I don't want to spoil fun, but to me it just looks like colored explosions, and of course that is exactly what it is actually. So a very happy new year to you all, and I got you guys a new video, and this is about a package that I got from Earache Records. So first off, I would like to congratulate Digby Pearson, who is of course the owner and founder of Earache Records, and everybody who works there, because this new year is their 25th anniversary. So guys, congratulations. A little while ago, Digby posted on his Facebook that he had an EP of the band Wormrot, which is a grindcore band from Singapore. And he told people, like, you know, I got like 100 copies, and if you want to have one, just send me your name and address and I'll send you one. So I sent him a message like, you know, could I have one? Could you add my name on the list? And he was like, don't worry, I'll send you a package. So a few days later, I got an envelope and it said Earache Records, and I was like, hey, the new Wormrot EP. And I was like, wait a minute, this envelope is a little bit thicker than I expected. So I ripped the envelope open, and in it was of course the Wormrot EP, but also a few extra CDs and a few patches. And the patches are in the mess somewhere over there. And of course I'm going to tell you guys about the new Wormrot EP, but I'm going to start off with the new Evile. And this is their third full-length album. It's called Five Serpent's Teeth, and it's a very good album actually. It's a little bit different than the first two, which I also got. The first two albums concentrate a little bit more on the speedy, thrashy side of the thrash metal, and this album has a little bit more diversity in songs. A fast song, a somewhat slower song, mid-temp song, but still some very awesome songs. In Dreams of Terror, Cult, Eternal Empire, Origin of Oblivion. In Memoriam is a really good song, a little bit more mid-tempo song. And Descent into Madness, it's 10 songs long. It's the first album without Mike Alexander on bass, who sadly died after the second album. But it's the first album with Joel Graham on bass, and Joel does an awesome job as well. So I'm just gonna show you guys the whole stuff. This is the album, and just like I, yeah, this is the back of the album. I hope you guys can see a little bit without too much light in it. I like the artwork actually, because it has snakes. Yeah. Inside, what do we got? Lyrics. No, I won't make the same joke again. That's a band picture of the guys, that's Evile, and on the back there's another band picture of the guys. So it's really good Bay Area thrash metal, and yeah, I really like it actually. I read a couple of comments of people who said like, it's so different from what they made before, and I was like, yeah, it sounds a little bit different, but not too different, you know. So I can really recommend this stuff if you like thrash metal, because some people were asking me after my Q&A 11, like, don't you like thrash metal? And, you know, of course I was like, I like this genre and like that genre, and I forgot to pick a thrash metal CD. I got old school thrash metal. I like Creator, I like Slayer, I like Testament. I recently updated my thrash metal collection a pretty bit. I bought 16 CDs from a good friend of mine, but there will be another video which was practically all thrash metal, Annihilator, Anthrax and stuff like that. And I also like new thrash metal, because if you can see it in the back, this is a very good album which you can also check out. It's Havoc, Time Is Up, also a very good recommendable album. So yes, I do really like thrash metal. So I'm gonna pick out a song for you guys to let you guys listen to, and I picked In Dreams of Terror, which is the second song of this album. Go check it out. Evile, off of Earache Records. Now the EP where my message to Digby all started with, Wormrot with Noise. It's 5 songs long, and Digby told me that there was a little bit confusion about this EP, because not because of the Wormrot EP itself, but what it says on the top, and it says Scion AV presents Wormrot Noise, and I'll show you guys. I hope. Yeah, that's it, right over there. Now Scion is a car company, and Scion decided to promote a grindcore EP, and Scion is also responsible, and I hope I can find it somewhere, yeah, for this Immolation EP, which is called Providence, which is also presented by Scion. Now, some people thought it was a corporate scam, and what does a car company got to do with grindcore or death metal, and you know, you should keep those things apart, and I was like, I don't really see the problem. If Scion decides to promote a grindcore band which results in a free EP for a lot of people, I really don't see a problem. And it's not like selling out because, oh, I get something for free so you can promote it. I mean, everybody wins. Just like Digby said, Scion gets a little bit of extra promotion for themselves, and a lot of people get a free EP. Earache is helped with it. So as long as everybody wins and not just one company, I don't really see a problem with that, you know. I'm already happy that they made a real EP and not just a download, because I don't download. Free or not, I do not download. I like real stuff. So that being said, it's a really good EP. If you like grindcore, then you should really go get some Wormrot, because it's really, really awesome grindcore. And of course, I'm gonna let you guys listen to a song of it. And I chose song 2, False Assumptions. And I don't know if I should cut it, because it's a song that lasts for 47 seconds. And it's not really comparable with like a big name such as Napalm Death, which is also grindcore. It sounds a little bit different. These guys, in my opinion, sound a little bit more thrashy, more raw than Napalm Death itself, but still a very good EP, and I'm really happy that Digby sent it to me. So go check it out, Wormrot on Earache Records. Very good CD. They last year, yeah, which is just a few days ago. But last year they brought out a CD. It's called Dirge, and I checked out that CD, and it's also a very good one. So I'm about thinking to go with that one as well. And yeah, I'll just let you guys listen to the song, and I'll just shut the hell up. False Assumptions, which is song 2 on this EP, Wormrot. And then the third and last album that Digby sent me. When I was first looking at the cover, I was like, what am I looking at, you know? What is this kind of music? But then when I started playing the music, I was like, holy shit. And it became one of my favorite albums in a short period of time. It's not death metal, it's not black metal, it's not thrash metal, nor grindcore or deathcore. It's just plain old heavy metal. And this is as old school as you can get it. And I'm talking about Flying Tigers of White Wizard. And when you hear the music, and of course I'm gonna let you guys listen to a piece of it, you'll probably think like, dude, you're so much into death metal and you like this kind of stuff. I love this kind of stuff. This stuff sounds actually as if it comes right out of the 1980s, and it's been produced last year. You know, it's so old school. And it's another album that I like from the beginning to the end. I like every song on this album. I just love the vocals. This guy just cuts right through your bones. He's called Wyatt Screaming Demon Anderson. Sadly enough, and I read this on a few different pages, he's no longer with White Wizard, which is really sad. And I haven't heard their new singer yet, so I can't judge if he's any good. But Wyatt Anderson was just an awesome, awesome vocalist. And I'll just show you guys a little bit of the booklet, because these guys really made some work out of the booklet. Like I said, this is the front cover, and it's a really pleasure to open up a booklet and to see, of course, lyrics, but also a picture that says something about the lyrics. There you go. And here we go. Flying Tigers, Star Child, really awesome artwork in it. Let me see. Yeah, Blood on the Pyramids. I mean, go check that out. That is just awesome. And yeah, I'm really happy with this album. Like I said, it's just one of my favorites currently, and will stay one of my favorites. I put the music on one of my MP3 players that I got, and I got it at work. It's just an amazing album. I really recommend it if you like old school heavy metal. And I'm gonna let you guys listen to the first song, which is my personal favorite. It's called Fight to the Death. And just to make sure, YouTube, I got personal approval of Digby Pearson, who's the owner and founder, I'm gonna say it again, of Earache Records, and he owns all of this music, so I've got permission from him personally. I'm gonna let you guys listen to this stuff. Fight to the Death, go check it out. I just love this stuff. Digby, thank you so much for all the stuff you sent me, and we're gonna stay in touch. And again, congratulations with your 25th anniversary, dude. See you guys later.
Bye.
be funny as hell if you walk into a hospital and there's an entire line of people, you know, covering their eyes because of the firework injuries they got. And you see this guy coming in like, and the nurse goes like, yes, another firework injury, I assume. No, I opened the champagne bottle. Ah, son of a...